one of the fundamental principles in Hinduism is diversity, and therefore there are diverse meals in Hinduism. There is no one fixed thing. Hinduism is a polytheistic faith, different gods, different kinds of food habits. And so there's no such thing as an ideal Hindu meal. There would be vegetarians, non-vegetarians, eggetarians, all kinds of meat, all kinds of plants and fruits. What I think unique things about the Indian way of eating food, where all food is served in a thali, and you mix and match it in different proportions depending on what you want to eat. And if you don't want to eat something, just take the katora and keep it out. Vegetarianism is neither a virtue nor a non-virtue. In the monastic order, which begins with Buddhism, Jainism, and the Tapasvi and Yogi traditions of India, there was a desire to keep away from all things worldly. And it is in these monastic orders that vegetarianism emerged. They equated vegetarianism at one level with good health, at another level with not doing cruelty to animals. Because many rituals involved the sacrifice of animals. But the other school of thought, which is the householder school of thought, said life is violent, living is violent, and all living creatures and all culture sustains itself by feeding on living things. So it is an idealistic, romantic notion that there will be no violence. Some violence is visible, some is invisible, some is direct, some is indirect, and therefore Bali is a critical part of bhog. So these two schools of thoughts exist, and it is from the monastic tradition that vegetarianism comes and gradually is adopted by the upper castes in India, and this becomes kind of a Sanskritization process, which is basically to associate yourself with the upper castes and upper classes and the elite in society, you shun non-vegetarian food. But if you look at India as a whole, all the communities, all the castes, all the sects across the country, there is, I would say most people do eat non-vegetarian food. So you can't equate vegetarian food with Hinduism. That's, not a correct way of looking at the Hinduism from a bird's eye view. That's a very narrow vision of Hinduism. There are no commandments in Hinduism. There are practices which change over space and time. And different practices exist in different times. For example, 2000 years ago, 3000 years ago, there were no temples and temple worship. There was yajna which is happening. It's only in recent times, the last 2000 years, temples have been built. So we see rituals have changed. The goddess in Hinduism is offered blood sacrifice, and that's part of her ritual. She is called Rakta Vilasini. Fish is offered to the goddess, and especially in the Shakto Parampara and the Shakti across India. So buffalo is slaughtered, goats are slaughtered, roosters are given to her, fish is given to her. It's only North India, like in Punjab, the goddess is vegetarian, and that's a unique feature of the North India. So it's not one or the other, it's both. The cow was always a goddess. All animals are gods and goddesses. The rat is worshipped because it is associated with Ganesha. The boar is worshipped as a form of Vishnu. So different animals are worshipped in different ways. Everything is sacred. Everything is sacred. Every plant is sacred. Every animal is sacred. That doesn't stop us from not consuming them. As consumers, we will consume in order to satisfy our hunger and to stay alive. So that's a larger philosophy. If someone asks that why is beef not eaten by Hindus, every community defines itself through certain ritual practices. For example, Jewish people have kosher meat. Same way the Muslim communities will not eat pork. There are taboo foods in every religion. In the same way, not eating beef is a way of defining Hindus. But it's not really the word beef, it is not eating cow meat. It doesn't mean bull meat or buffalo meat or buff meat. So there's, nowadays the definition of cow meat has extended itself to everything, whether it's bull or buffalo. I don't know who comes up with these translations. It's, I think, perhaps to extend the definition of beef has certain political basis to it. In Ayurvedic texts, non-vegetarian food is eaten. There are lots of Ayurvedic texts which talk about it. The great chef Nala has a book, it's called Nala, from Nala Damayanti, has a book on the best cuisines, in which he talks about the first biryani, and he talks about meat being eaten, different kinds of meat in different seasons. So these are all part of Indian tradition. And so beef becomes a caste marker, a religious marker. It defines who you are. It doesn't make you superior or inferior, because Atma is everywhere.